Are you a graphic designer and you got hired for a job that is or includes a map? And you're like, a map?
Am I gonna have to trace a bunch of stuff?
I'll show you how to get started by exporting map vectors in exquisite detail.
And of course, there's the obvious bonus of getting to call yourself a cartographer.
I'll show you two versions of this trick, Padawan mode and Jedi Knight mode. This is ArcGIS Online, and you'll notice I'm not signed in. Anyone can use this. This is a global vector base map. Every time I zoom in, additional detail is revealed. With each step, more layers are added, and those layers have more resolution. Is it possible to export these layers as glorious design-ready vectors? Yes. But before we export, let's take a look at our options. There are about a kajillion different base maps that you can pick from, and each is unique. It may have different data, and it'll definitely have different styles. And if you don't see what you like in this list, search Living Atlas for about a bajillion more. A good option for designers is OpenStreetmap because it's thorough and its data is available under an open license. We'll export data using this print option. In our first order of business, we'll be using this map only tab. You can set your output pixel dimensions here. Let's take a look at our export format options. We have PNG, which is a flattened bitmap. Can't edit that. Same with JPEG and GIF, or GIF, if you're really into peanut butter. EPS and PDF will give you vectors, which we want. AIX is a magical format that I'll talk about a little bit later. I'm gonna stick with PDF, and I'll give it a name, since you've been gone, and hit export. Oh, it's ready. It's pretty fast. And now the result is a nice scalable vector graphic in PDF format, which I can save and open in whatever I want, like Illustrator, or whatever tool you beautiful graphic designers are using these days. But remember how as we zoomed in, we got more and more layers at higher detail? Let's say you want to keep your map's footprint the same, but pull in more of that detailed data. You might look into these advanced options and say, oh, there's a DPI. I'll just turn this up and boost my detail. But it turns out it's not boosting the detail within your area of interest. It just makes the area of interest bigger. Worth a shot. I'll set this back. What I really want is this level of detail. But then when I update my width and height to get back to my original footprint, it's blown out of view and I can't find it. I'm flying blind. And if I zoom out to find it, I can't see it. And I've lost out on all that detail that I like. What I really need is a gigantic monitor that lets me zoom all the way into the detail that I want, but is big enough to still show me that footprint way out here. And I have what you'd call a very normal sized monitor. But the cool thing about our map is it's in a browser, and a browser can lie about its size. You press the Control or Command key, and then minus. Everything looks smaller because your browser has virtually become bigger. Minus, minus, minus. This browser can pretend to be gigantic. All right, let's give it a go. Control, minus, 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 minus. Yes, exquisite detail, and we can see our big footprint. The browser has tricked the web map into thinking it's living in a monitor that's twice as wide and twice as tall, or four times the area than it really is. Let's export this, and it can be hard to read because everything's so itty bitty. Oh, it's done. Okay, let's open this new giant PDF in a new tab and download it. And here's the new bigger export in Illustrator. By way of comparison, this new more detailed PDF comes in at 1.2 megabytes. The previous one was 717 kilobytes. And to visually compare them, here's the previous lower resolution export.
So if you're a graphic designer and you see a map commission, take it. You can do this.
But watch out, it's a slippery slope. Making maps is fun, and it's not just base map stuff. ArcGIS Online is packed with the stuff that you're probably gonna need for these commissions, like boundaries, demographics, contour lines, fire perimeters, satellite imagery, hill shade, flood zones, school districts. There's no end to the sorts of maps that you'll be able to make and want to make. Now I've got one more level for you, and it's Force Ghost mode. Here is where you can download the succinctly named ArcGIS Maps for Adobe Creative Cloud. It's an extension that fully integrates data and maps into the Adobeverse. And you can take it from there, but remember that AIX format that we saw in the export options? It'll give you beautifully formatted clean layers and nice continuous text. So get your stylish graphic designer hands all over this data and start taking those commissions. It is your destiny.